Hi dears, today we are moving on to the next portion in our chapter, that is pollination. As we have studied that the male gamete in a flower is pollen grain and the female gamete in a flower is egg within the embryo sac. Isn't it? So we have discussed about the detailed structure of a male gametophyte, male gamete, that is pollen grain, and also the female gametophyte, that is embryo sac, and the formation of embryo sac and all, isn't it? So these two, the male gamete and female gamete in a flower is non-motile. So how the fertilization will occur? They need to come close with each other so that the fertilization will be occur. So that process, the transfer of this male and female gamete which come in contact with each other is carried out with the help of a process called pollination. Okay, so pollination is the process of transfer of pollen grain from the stigma, from the anther of a flower to the stigma of a pistil. Okay, pollination is the transfer of pollen or pollen grain to the stigma of a pistil. So the picture itself we have discussed in our previous class. So the transfer of a pollen grain from the anther to the stigma of a pistil is called as pollination. So pollination is important to carry out the fertilization. So the flowering plants will show different adaptations to perform this pollination. There are several external factors which will helps to carry out the pollination in flower. So now we are going to discuss the different types of pollination. Okay. The first one is autogamy. Autogamy, or we can say it self pollination. So in autogamy, the pollen grain from the anther is transferred to the stigma of the same flower. Okay, so the pollen grain from the anther is transferred to the stigma of the same flower. So there occurs the self pollination without the involvement of a pollinator. Okay, so the flower itself, the anther and stigma are seen close with each other. But the complete autogamy is a rare phenomena, but it requires a great synchrony in the pollen release and the stigma receptibility. Then only the process of self-pollination occur. So there is no chance of occurrence of cross-pollination. Okay, and according to this, there are two different types of flowers, that are chasmogamous flower. Chasmogamous flower. Chasmogamous flower and cleistogamous flower. Okay, and this chasmogamous flower is the anther and stigma are close with each other, but it is open or exposed. Okay, but in the case of a cleistogamous flower, the flower is partially opened. Okay, so the anthers and stigma are very close with each other and it is not exposed. So the chances of occurrence of cross pollination is very low. within the so the occurrence of autogamy is promoted in this flowers, cleistogamous flowers and also chasmogamous flowers. And the examples of flowers that carry out autogamy is Viola, Oxalis, Camelina. Viola, Oxalis, Camelina are the plants, are the flowers which carry out this self-pollination. Okay, so there are two types of flowers, chasmogamous flower and cleistogamous flower. It is the anthers and stigma are exposed, and in cleistogamous flower it is partially opened, so the it is closed within the flower, so the chance of occurrence of pollination, self pollination, is higher in this case.
This is a chasmogamous flower in which anthers and stigma are exposed, and this is a cleistogamous flower.
And in the case of cleistogamous flower, it is assured seed set is present, because the chances of getting fertilization and the formation of a seed and fruit and seed is higher in this case. Okay, so in this case the assured seed set is there. And then we are moving on to the next type of pollination, that is geitonogamy. First one is autogamy and the second one is geitonogamy. Okay, this is the process of transfer of pollen grain from the anther to the stigma of another flower of the same plant. Okay, it is the process of transfer of pollen grain from the anther to the stigma of a different flower of same plant. Okay, so there is a occurrence of cross pollination with the help of a pollinator. So here the flowers need a pollinator to carry out the cross pollination among the flowers of the same plant. Okay, so it requires a pollinator, but it is genetically similar to autogamy. Why say so? Because the pollen grains are from the same flower and the ovules are also in the same plant. Okay, there is no difference in plants. The flowers are within the plant. So the genetic there is no genetic difference in the case of a pollen grain. So genetically similar to autogamy. And the third one is coenogamy. Here in this case, the pollen grains from the anther is transferred to the stigma of another flower of another plant. So in between two plants, the pollination occur in this case. So it is genetically and morphologically different with each other. There is no genetic similarity. The pollen grains are from different plants. Okay. So the coenogamy is the transfer of pollen grain from the anther to the stigma of another flower of another plant. It occurs in between the plants, but geitonogamy is occur within the plant itself, but the flowers are different. But in autogamy, the same flower carrying out the pollination. Okay, and that's all about the different types of pollination. And then we moving on to the agents of pollination, the agents which carry out pollination. There are biotic and abiotic agents to carry out pollination. So the abiotic agents are, the major abiotic agents are water and wind. and important biotic agents are animals. Biotic means living, okay, and abiotic means non-living. Biotic agents are animals like honey bees, butterflies, etc. And majority of plants are using the biotic agents to carry out the pollination. Okay, and in some cases only the abiotic agents are carrying out pollination. Okay, and as we know that pollen grains are produced in enormous amount. For what? Yes, the pollen grains are produced in enormous quantity because it is easy to carry out the pollen grains by wind and water. So it will get lost. The chances of losing pollen grain is high. So in order to avoid such a condition, the pollen grains are produced in enormous quantity. But in the case of a ovule, it is seen within the female reproductive structure, because it is protected within the floral parts. So it is not exposed to the wind and water. But in the case of pollen grain, it is exposed. So the chances of getting losing is high. That's why the pollen grains are produced in enormous quantity. Okay. So then we moving on to the next, that is pollination by wind. What are the features of wind pollinator flowers and what are the peculiarities? Okay, wind pollination. So the pollen grains for this wind pollination is light and non-sticky pollen grains. So for the wind pollination, light and non-sticky pollen grains are required, and also feathery stigma is present. Large feathery stigma to trap the airborne pollen grains. Large feathery stigma to trap the airborne pollen grains. The stamens are well exposed for the dispersal to the wind current. Okay, so the stamens are well exposed. And also numerous flowers are packed into form an inflorescence. Numerous flowers are packed into an inflorescence. And also there is a single ovule within a single ovary. Okay, there is a single ovule within the ovary of the flowers. Single ovule is there. And the wind pollination is quite common in the case of grasses. Okay, so these are the special features of wind pollinated flowers, that is the pollen grains are light and non-sticky, and also large feathery stigma is present, and stamens are well exposed, and inflorescence, the flowers are clustered to form the inflorescence, and there is a single ovule in each ovary. And the examples for flowers to carry out the wind pollination are mainly in grass plants. Okay, and that's all about today, and the rest we will discuss in our next class. Okay, thank you.